Plans that I had in the future. I remember I was thinking about babies, whether a boy or girl, and what we would name it. It hurts we never made it. I just assumed that you lied when you told me you never leave me, cause you deceived me, you so misleading, my heart is...
Hey guys, Crisp Christ checking in. I know I said last video that I had a nice unboxing to do, and that's what I'm gonna get done today. I have had my first CGC signature submission sitting at my house for about a week now. I am just drowning in anticipation, but I wanted to make sure to get it in a video. And the reason why I waited partially is because I also got in this little package right here a grail that I've wanted for a very long time. It is a 0.5, but it's a grail nonetheless, and it's the first time I've ever actually been able to obtain a grail of mine. Sorry. But, and I've got a couple little eBay purchases in the mix. Figured I'd roll everything together and, get you guys a decent sized video. So, without further ado, let us start with the Signature Series unboxing. So, I know I told you guys I sent a couple books in for the James Tinian IV signing at CGC, which, once again, I've never sent in a book for a CGC grading or signing. I've only sent in the Ricky Riddle book that I have back behind me for a slabbing and verification through CBCS. So this is my first time with CGC, and I'm very excited to see what grades I got and how they turned out. I bought all the books straight off the shelf, so I really, really hope that I got a good grade. There's nothing I have that I got on the secondhand market. Oh my god, I love that packaging, CGC. Thank you. What else we got? Invoice. All right. Saving the bubble wrap. Always gotta save the bubble wrap. All right. So I don't know these grades. I'm praying that they are 9.8s, because once again, straight off the shelf, into a long box, and then straight to CGC. So first off, oh, 9.6. That sucks. No big deal though. I mean, it's still beautiful, and if you know anything, a 9.6 is basically a 9.8. This is Something's Killing the Children, number one, the local comic book shop variant. Love that signature in gold by James. That is really pretty. With all the, Something's Killing the Children hype, I just had to get a book in. And luckily, even after the hype, I was at my local comic book shop and they just had this copy in the back for $4. So I guess I got a little lucky with that one. Next up, we've got 9.6 again. What is this? Damn. We've got a copy of Year of the Villain, Hell's Arisen 3, which is the first cameo, I believe. I don't think it's the first appearance. It's the first cameo. No, first full appearance of Punchline. Yes. This is a third printing, which is totally fine with me because I like the difference in the printings is the hue of like the background fire. And in this one, it's purple, which I think goes beautifully with the Joker's purple hue, and I requested that James sign it in purple as well, so I think that looks really good. It sucks that it's a 9.6 though. That's crazy. I guess that's, you know, that's always the chance whenever you roll the dice with sending some books in. But dang, these are brand new books, like straight fresh off the press. I don't see anything wrong with them. I'm not like two into grading. Oh, okay, I see one spine tick. That sucks, but regardless, very nice copy. It's for the PC anyway, so I love that. All right, and then last but not least, okay, yes, there we go. A 9.8 at last. It is Batman 89, which is the cameo. Yes, first appearance of Punchline in cameo, face not revealed. And I had James sign up here. Really dig his signature. It's very long, but short and precise. Like that a lot, and that looks great. I can't believe that though. The one book that I didn't find the best looking of the three is the one that got the 9.8. That sucks. But hey, you know, you win some, you lose some, no big deal. And 9.6, like I said, I mean, if we're being honest, 9.6 is a 9.8. For the most part, I mean, what's one little tick on there? Okay, next, something that I know the grade of already. There is no room for disappointment. Which, I mean, I'm not disappointed in that. That's nice. I'm just happy that I finally got to send in some books and get them back already. It only took about... don't quote me, because I'm not 100%. And I'm sure somebody else knows the answer to this. But I sent off the books to get signed, 5 weeks ago? So getting them back so quickly is very nice. Even when I just sent in... Oh, she's packed tight. Even when I sent in the book just for verification for CBCS back there, it took 6 months. It was insane. I couldn't even comprehend why it took so long. I mean, verification can't be that difficult of a process. Ooh, okay. Digging the pack job. Okay. Here we are. Here is the Grail. And I got this book actually from a claim sale over the weekend. I was scrolling through and I made an Instagram page for the channel, and I've been getting a lot of response from the comic community, which is really nice. And I was just scrolling through claim sales and I found some people I'd never seen before, which was Underdog Comics. And I was lucky enough to see them before they sold this bad boy. And they were very nice over there. The guy was talking about how during the pandemic, he had lost his job, but then decided to take that opportunity to, go after comic book selling, which is a hobby. And so I just thought it was really nice to hear that somebody had some kind of luck throughout this pandemic. You know, I know it's been devastating for everyone. My parents own a restaurant, which luckily we've been very fortunate through this whole situation. But on a lighter note, I got myself a Batman 181. I know it's really beat up, but this is the first appearance of Poison Ivy. And it's a book I've wanted for a very long time. And the price just skyrocketed. I remember I heard, I think it was Como Comics or someone started talking about how it was an underrated key. And I immediately thought to myself, I better go get it, because it's about to shoot up in price. But luckily, I was willing to settle with some defects. I hate the fact that it's ripped up here. That's my one thing that I won't compromise on most of the time. I'm okay with color rub and bends and stuff like that, especially on an old book. But the rip really sucks. But I will upgrade. You have my word. At some point in the future, I will upgrade this book. That is a promise to you and myself. But I'm very, very happy that I finally got it. And thank you to Underdog Comics. They were very pleasant. Once again, just hearing about their story, and they're reasonable with me about price, and they shipped immediately. It was very quickly. Everything was done very, very well, and I love their pack job, by the way. Like, they packed it properly. That's always something scary to deal with for the first time with a new seller. I also got, from Underdog Comics, again, another little mini grail, I guess, just because the hype from the movie, when Godzilla vs. Kong came out, I know everybody was freaking out for a second, and I just thought, oh, that's kind of cool, you know, get the first appearance of Godzilla in comic books, that's kind of cool. So, they had a first appearance of Godzilla. I think it was like a 4.0 or something. So, oh, guys, you did a no-no. Put some tape on a comic? That's a no-no. Okay, luckily it was unscathed. But they get, oh cool, they gave me a couple free comics with, along with my, that's really cool, man. They gave me a little, Something's Killing the Children. Ironically, how ironic is that? I mean, coincidental, that is so coincidental. Since I bought the Grail and, the Godzilla number one, they just gave me a couple free books, which one of them is just going over, I think, the first volume of Something's Killing the Children, which in all the hype to make sure that I got a 9.8 that I didn't get, I never took out Something's Killing the Children. I never actually read it, unfortunately. So now I'll be able to figure out what what all this hype's about. That's really awesome. Thanks again, you guys. Okay, and then what is this other free comic? We got JSA All-Stars. Fair Play. I've never heard of this. But that is interesting. I will give that a look. Yeah, I will definitely give that a look later. Thank you so much, guys. That was really awesome. Once again, if you haven't checked them out, Underdog Comics, I will definitely put a link below. I always try to put a link for anybody I mention. And the video. I still can't believe that. What a coincidence. Right on my signature unboxing, I got Something's Killing the Children for free. In an overview book. That's freaking awesome. Oh, that's always the scariest part. I don't like knives being this close to my comics. If we can get through here. Okay. All right. Chill out. All right. There you go. Last but not least, from Underdog Comics, we got a Godzilla. I'm trying to get that angle right. We've got a Godzilla number one. First appearance of Godzilla in comic books. I thought that was a cute little thing to get because they were selling it pretty cheap. Looks pretty decent. I'm not a big fan of the fact that he looks so much like Reptar. Love me some Reptar, but come on now. All right, yes, awesome. Definitely made up for the little 9.6s, which once again, I'm not too upset. I mean, knew it could have happened. I'm still trying to get the whole grading thing. Trying to get like an idea of how to grade and what to look for. Still pretty new when it comes to that stuff. I've only been like full-fledged collecting as an adult for like a year and a half, maybe two. And I know some people are really big into grading, which, I mean, you kind of have to be if you are collecting to know prices and stuff like that. But here we got a book that I got right after I purchased that grail of mine to go with my theme that I try to keep going in the background back there. I'll put a link to the video where I go over what kind of system I got going behind me. But if I can get it, what's up with the tape? These guys these days just taping everything together. Craziness. Okay, so don't mind the fact that the bag got ripped a little bit from the tape, but I got really lucky with this virgin variant of Harley Quinn Poison Ivy by Shannon Mayer. Oh, also with the certificate of authenticity. The certificate authenticates this copy of Harley Quinn and Poison Ivy number 1, Ivy Virgin Variant by Shannon Mayer, as one of 500 available for retail purchase. This is number 107. Excellent. So in the video, like I've stated before, I try to get a first appearance of a character and then a modern take on their character, and I put them next to each other. So I'm definitely gonna have to send in this virgin variant. I really hope that the people over at it's just gorgeous too. Jesus Christ, that is a very gorgeous cover. Hopefully they have Shannon up there to do signing over at CGC or CBCS. As I've said before, I definitely think the CBCS slab looks just a bit better. Just a bit better than the CGC one. Geez, this is just absolutely gorgeous cover. And I got very lucky. It was on eBay, and I know the just the minimal variant where the title is very minimal in the top left corner, that one goes for like $40. And the virgin variant goes for about 50 or 60. And I, right after I purchased the Grail and I confirmed that it was coming to me, I Googled the best Poison Ivy covers, modern, you know. And they had an auction going on and it was about to end, and I swung this thing for only $22. So I know that the variant crowd is very frantic and will definitely give you a run for your money whenever it comes to a sought after variant. So I feel very lucky to end up getting that for so cheap. And the last thing that I got, I can't even remember now, actually. This last one's just gonna be a little Christmas present on top of the couple that I've already got in this. Oh yeah, okay. I was also participating in a claim sale with the man behind the red hood, which I'll link him again. I've linked him in other videos. I definitely like doing business with the guys over there. But I was kind of flipping back and forth between Underdog and Golden Age Guru and Under the Red Hood, and couldn't really find anything that they had a nice Batman. I think it's 164, the first appearance of Tim Drake as Robin. But it was just a little out of my price range, so I waited a couple of hours flipping back and forth, and I found a low grade comic that is another one of my quote-unquote grails. Not really a grail, just something I've been meaning to get. It is the first appearance of Dick Grayson as Nightwing in Teen Titans number... Oh, Tales of the Teen Titans number 44? 44, I believe. And it's a part of the Judas contract, which part of the reason why I seek these Teen Titan titles out so much is because I watched the Teen Titans on Cartoon Network when I was a kid. And the Judas contract was just such an amazing arc. Like, definitely goes down as one of my all-time favorite arcs in any cartoon or show, period. I think it's fantastic, and hopefully I don't get them back too late. It doesn't take too long. I just sent off a CGC shipment of just random books here and there, and one of them was the first appearance of Tara, who you'll know from the Judas Contract. She's the one who betrays the team for Slade. And so that's two of the appearances that I need. Oh, and I also got a first appearance of the Red X, which is another character from Teen Titans that I really love. I'm just trying to like complete the collection of first appearances of the characters that I know and love from the show. Because, I mean, I feel like that's where most people, at least these days, most people start out loving a character based on a show or a movie, and then they kind of collect the comic second. I try to avoid that as much as possible. I try to like get into the comic first and then enjoy the cinematic, you know, realizations of them. That's part of the reason why Godzilla wasn't like the biggest book on my list, because obviously it's a film first. It's not the comic first, which, you know, isn't my forte. But, you know, I thought it was neat. Everybody loves Godzilla. Well, at least I do. I love Godzilla for sure. But, that's all I got for you guys today. I'm also experimenting with a new camera. Let me know what you think of it. I was thinking it looked pretty crisp up there. I'm trying to work on the angle. That's why it's so high up. I got a tripod for it. And I'm still experimenting with where I'm going to put it. Because going from this tiny little webcam, which is easy to just mount anywhere, to this big camera is a bit of an adjustment. But if you have any suggestions for equipment or anything like that, I'm definitely going to be doing some research on how to do this properly without being in the way and taking up too much room. Because I don't know if you guys can tell, but there's not a whole bunch of room in my room. Fortunately, my lovely wife shares this space with me, even though I'm taking over my half of it with just the nerdiest things imaginable. But once again, my wife is a lovely lady and lets me get away with it, so it's all good. But all right, guys, like and subscribe. And I will catch you guys later.